guest this segment is Rob Nicoleski. He's the National Energy Correspondent for Watchdog.org. Rob, thanks for holding through that break. We do appreciate your time and what you do.
Great. Yeah, no problem.
You know, Rob, great article, by the way. It's packed with information. This guy, Jagadish Shukla, I guess that's how you pronounce his name, that you have some very interesting facts about him that he received, and you mentioned this before, $333,000 in compensation from this organization, IGES, which is the Institute for Global Environment and Society. You also have in here, and by the way, that was for a 28-hour-a-week job. That's one heck of a part-time job, Rob, isn't it?
Yeah, that's pretty good money.
Now, interestingly, you also have in here, his wife received over $166,000, and that his daughter is also on the payroll. Rob, I've learned a long time ago, follow the money trail on these people. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, I mean, that's, and, you know, when I was talking to Anna in the previous break, or in the previous segment, that's, I think, what really makes the story interesting, because, you know, the whole climate debate has been very polarized, and depending on which side of the aisle you're on, you can find facts to back up what you're saying. But what is at the nub of this is the money, and whether or not this is against the law of Virginia, since Dr. Shukla works for a public university. There are very specific laws in Virginia about double dipping. And I think that's where the rubber is going to meet the road here, because this is going to be more than just a debate about whether or not Dr. Shukla is an alarmist or whether or not he's being factual or not. I mean, that's a whole different story. When you get down to money and you get down to the letter of the law, then it's going to be a lot more difficult to determine, well, this was just a matter of opinion or a difference of opinion. So I think this story is going to be something that's going to go on for a while. I'm going to follow it because I think eventually we're going to get to the bottom of this thing.
Well, it points to me that I certainly got into the wrong business. You know, we're throwing around these numbers, Rob. $333,000. $166,000, and people might want to know where this comes from. Thank you for putting it into the article that this organization, the Institute of Global Environment and Society, has gotten $63 million in taxpayer-funded grants since 2001. That's a lot of money, Rob.
Yeah, I think that brings up another point to this this whole debate that gets very partisan. Is a lot of times the stories from the media, stories especially from the green side of the equation, always talk about the quote evil oil companies and all the money that they're spending. But in the Shukla situation, and these numbers are not made up; they're from the IRS, and you can look them up. And there's the links on my story. They're IRS filings for these numbers, and I think that a lot of times we'll hear from the left, oh, big oil, you know, is funding these things. There's lots of money behind them. But they don't talk about the fact that there's also a lot of money coming in from the other side of the coin as well. And that often gets overlooked. But I think in this case, it's going to be difficult for people to overlook that because the numbers are very large.
Rob, I also wanted to point out something else that was in your article about this Shukla. He was the lead signatory of a September letter from 20 climate scientists calling on Barack Obama, Attorney General Loretta Lynch, and the head of the White House Office of Science and Technology Policy to use the RICO statutes. RICO, Racketeer Influence and Corruption Organization Act, to file civil lawsuits against corporations in the fossil fuel industry and their supporters.
Yep.
I mean,
that's another really interesting aspect of the story, is because Shukla was the lead signatory of this letter that came out on September 1st. And that ticked off a number of people, including Judith Miller, who I've talked about earlier in this broadcast. But the interesting thing, though, is that it got other people, especially critics of Dr. Shukla, to start looking into his finances. And as I said, these numbers come from IRS filings. And that's when people started seeing, oh, wow, he's made a lot of money. He makes $333,000 just last year for a job that pays him 28 hours, that he works 28 hours a week on. And are these numbers correct? Right? Is this double dipping? So the ironic thing is that he drew attention to himself by signing this letter, but it's now boomerang back on him because now he's under investigation from Congressman Smith.
Rob, I'm chuckling as we're talking because this number, 28 hours a week, keeps banging in my head. That's part-time, Rob. Even according to Obamacare, that's part-time. He wouldn't even qualify to get Obamacare from his employee because he works less than 30 hours a week. I mean, it's...
and a $333,000 a year plus the $314,000 a year he makes at George Mason. I mean, he's making close to $700,000 a year. And I think that just, it's those numbers that jump out at you, because as we mentioned earlier, lots of people talk about all the big money that oil companies spend and energy companies spend. Well, there's some, you know, this is Exhibit A about the number of, or the amount of money, large amounts of money that's being spent on the other side.
Incredible, incredible. And this, you know, Rob, off topic. But what percentage of our electricity comes from fossil fuels?
Oh, I don't know off the top of my head.
Is it like 60 or 70?
It's like 90%, I think.
Yeah. So just think, they sue these people under the RICO statutes. They put them all out of business. What does it do to our country if we lose 90% of our electric?
Yeah, you know that's a good question. And what they wanted to do was they wanted to use the RICO statute, which is usually used against mafia figures, to investigate those people who they say are trying to suppress information about climate change.
And I think we have Anna back now. Anna, you are back with us now, right?
I am here.
All right, Anna. We only have about another minute. And you know, the idea that this guy, Shukla, is making so much money for part-time jobs, all of it at government. You know, you can say George Mason University, okay, well, where's that salary come from? Probably taxpayers. Hey, Rob, we want to thank you so much for joining us on the Conservative Commandos radio show. Rob Nicoleski, tell our audience where they can follow your work.
You can go to watchdog.org, and when you go to that first page, the watchdog.org page, there's a tab that says Energy. You can click on that. You can see all the energy stories I've written.
Great, great article. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rick. Thank you, Anna.
Anna, I'm sorry we lost you. We're wrapping up 30 seconds.
Well, listeners, remember, this is your government. It is up to you. We've got the budget and the debt ceiling. You've got to get on the horn on that. You've got to get the word around. Make sure you expose Planned Parenthood. Don't forget about Ukraine. And obviously, we need to plug in on this climate change thing because that's heating up too.
All right. I want to thank our guests, Rob Bluey from the Heritage Foundation, Craig Bannister from MRC TV, and our most recent guest, Rob Nicoleski, from watchdog.org. Want to thank Mr. John Forsyth for working the boards. Right now, we're out of time. We got to run. We got to go. Take care. God bless. We'll see you tomorrow on the radio.
Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on...
You're tuned in.